Hey, what's up, guys? It's Sliderick Dan here. Have you ever thought about doing extreme sports before? I mean, like, in my perspective, extreme sports, like skateboarding or snowboarding. Actually, if you've already done these kind of stuff and you're laughing at me because I'm saying these are extreme sports, well, just don't. So have you ever looked at like videos before on YouTube and like you're seeing all these like, you know, tricks with like BMX or like skateboards and like these guys are like falling off cliffs or doing 360s and whatnot and just like doing backflips on skateboards, which is absolutely insane. Well, guess what? That's not me. I am not in the slightest bit athletic at all. But what did catch my interest was a thing called a Onewheel, because it seems like every YouTuber out there has a Onewheel nowadays. It's crazy. What's going on? So, you know, I had to put myself out of my comfort zone and I decided to go ahead and get myself a Onewheel, even though I've never done any board sports before. So I'm super excited about this new Onewheel, and I have no idea what the heck I'm doing. So I mean, I guess it's just trial and error that I gotta learn. And forms. Forms really help, right? For the most part. Yeah, for the most part. Let's just put it that way. So this video is really about my first week of getting to know how to learn the Onewheel. I think this is a pretty unique perspective because I've seen some videos, YouTube videos out there with people who are a lot more athletic than me. And I mean, I know there's another video out there that explains it as a beginner perspective and he's never ridden anything like a skateboard before. But for me, like, not only have I not ridden a skateboard or a snowboard before, I'm just not really like coordinated at all and I'm really clumsy. I bump into things all the time. And yeah, I'm just, you know, not really naturally athletic. But anyways, let's cut to the chase. So this is the first week of me trying to learn how to ride the Onewheel.
I'm super, super excited. As you can see here, I got my own Onewheel. So I'm really excited. At the same time, I'm terrified because I've never tried any of these before. But I have watched tons and tons of like tutorial videos prior, and yeah, I got the app connected and everything, and so I guess the first step really is to just give it a shot. Let's give it a go. Oh gosh, that's terrifying. Yeah, we're not off to a good start. Okay, all right, and okay, so I'm on it, and this is pretty cool, but also at the same time, I'm having a hard time balancing here. I do have to learn how to get off too. I do recall in the videos that you're supposed to take your heel off, so let me try that. Let me try that. I think I got how to get on it now, so just gotta commit. Okay, all right. Here we go, and then I just gotta lift my heel. Oh, it worked, but sort of. It's still rolling. It didn't like stop me, but the motor stopped, so that's good. Okay, let's try that again. Okay. Ooh. Okay, just take the heel off. Oh, that was smooth. Nice, I got it. So when I bought the Onewheel, the reason why I bought it used, it became a super cool, like super dope float tier, and it already has one on there right now, and it's the more robust one from Future Motion. And so when I get better, I'm planning to put these on. And it came with extra grip tape and a couple stands, which is awesome. And so I think yeah, the real advantage to buying it used, and not to mention also the fender. So I'll definitely need that. Heel up. Okay, there we go. It's not that easy, but I'm sure I'll get the hang of it at some point. I mean, it is getting really late, so I think I'm gonna call it for that, and then tomorrow we're gonna go ahead, after I get off work, we're gonna get some practices in, and hopefully I can, I guess my goal for tomorrow is if I can go straight and backwards, like go forwards and backwards out, that'll be my goal, and if I could shut it off correctly. So that's my goal for tomorrow. All right, so on my one wheel. So I think I'm starting to get the hang of it now, sort of. Still can't turn very much, but at least I can move forward and backwards. There we go. You gotta lift your heel up like Michael Jackson. So, as you notice, I am a goofy, and I didn't figure that out until, well, I guess until I figured it out. I was trying to ride regular for the past couple days when I'm trying to start, and I noticed that I couldn't get any better, and so figures it's because I'm a goofy instead of a regular. So that helped a lot.
And I'm gonna pause this video for just a second here and interrupt myself, because this information was really critical for me becoming a better rider at the one wheel. So if you have no idea what I'm talking about right now, saying goofy or regular, that actually doesn't describe my condition of state of my mental health, but it does describe if my right foot or my left foot would go forward on the one wheel board, or in case any other board sports, your skateboard or your snowboard, etc., etc., and so on. So basically, you can see right now that my right foot is going forwards of the board. And so this basically means that I'm a goofy style rider. So if, for example, if my left foot was on the front and my right foot was on the back, so basically the opposite way around, then that would be a regular rider. Goofy and regular really doesn't mean anything. It's just kind of like whether you write with your right hand or you write with your left hand. And some people are ambidextrous, and that is the same way for any board sports too. Some people are fine with regular or goofy, but as for me, I was pretty much a strictly a goofy rider. If I tried to ride regular, then it really messed me up, like really bad. And so yeah, take this information if you want to find out if you are a goofy rider or regular rider. Basically, here I'm going to show you a clip here of a friend of mine recording me jumping over a puddle. So yeah, you can see that my right foot was going forward and landed first. So imagine yourself basically jumping over a puddle like this, or sliding over a carpet or ice, and whatever foot goes forward is the dominant foot that you should put in forwards. That'll determine whether you're a goofy or regular rider. Okay, resume.
All right, so this is day 4, and I got off work pretty late today. I apologize for it being kind of dark now. It's already past golden hour, so it's pretty much at sunset at this point. But yeah, I'm just gonna go ahead and practice on the grass real quick, kind of get a feel for it. Oh geez. Now, one thing that I did change as far as I guess like my riding, I did change my shoes. Now, it looks like the same shoes, but the padding, the inner sole inside of it, I swapped it out for one that suits better for flat-footed people. And I had it for a while. I just never used it because I guess, because I haven't been, you know, in a situation in my workplace where I have to like walk for a long time or run. And so I just, you know, I can deal with it. And so I had it in my shoe now. So hopefully that'll help. And I can ride for a little bit longer. Yeah, my foot is starting to get some cramps right now. So I'm trying to power through it, but it's really throwing off my balance. That's why I'm getting off the board. Oh, stop. Ah, my foot. Yeah. So the only time I'm really bailing out is because my foot is cramping. I guess it's a unique issue. Not everybody has this problem. So just got to figure out how to get used to it and relax. So once I'm relaxed, it's all good. Then again, it's easier said than done. Or either that, or my muscles will get trained over time and it just will stop cramping like it is right now, which hurts. Or I practice on the pavement. Right now, I don't have a helmet on because I ordered it off of Amazon and it's on its way. So that's why I'm trying to stick to the grass at this moment.
Dude, what is that?
It's a one wheel. Yeah. Whew. All right. Not bad, not bad. I was in a bad stint. I'm starting to get a cramp on my right foot, but my left foot is doing fine. 1.1 miles. We did it, guys. Our first continuous mile. I didn't do that. Surprisingly. Ledge and drop.
Well, there it is, guys. That's 1 week. And yeah, I just wanted to end this video with a few things just mentioning that might help new riders or people who really want to get the one wheel, but you're just not sure if it's the right thing for you. I want to start off actually with the first one, motivation factor. What I mean by this is really until I got into about like day six, I genuinely thought that I was never going to be able to learn how to ride the one wheel. I just thought I was just going to sell it and it's just not for me. And I see this all the time on the internet where people post their either for sale signs or just forum posts or say, hey, you know, I tried it. I don't think it's the right thing for me because I just can't improve. And what I really want to say is push through, because that's what I did. I wanted to at least give it a try for at least a solid month before I even remotely said, hey, this is not for me and I wanted to sell sell it. And so, yeah, just try it. And if you think that you're not getting any better, that's the moments that you really have to push through and give it a couple weeks. And if you're really trying for a couple weeks, I assure you, because I'm on a slow learning curve right now compared to other people, I assure you that you will get there. And yeah, and leading up to that, I wanted to mention the second thing, which is pushback. So if you don't know what pushback is, basically once the one wheel gets close to its limitation, then it'll lift the board up, and that way it's basically letting you know, I'm getting close to the limit, so you should probably slow down a bit. Pushback is mentioned a lot in the forums, especially for beginners, and because it's really important to know, and it could be very dangerous if you ignore the pushback, because you can straight off nosedive and, you know, you'll eat it. But for me, pushback wasn't very relevant because I wasn't anywhere near going 15 miles an hour, which is where pushback basically starts in either delirium or mission mode. And so, yeah, I wanted to mention, be aware of it, but if you are going really slow, don't stress over it too much. Now, speaking about delirium and mission modes, so I wanted to mention digital shaping. So this digital shaping, what it is, it's on your app on your phone, and when you connect it to your one wheel via Bluetooth, you can change the mode setting on it. The main two modes that people recommend is mission or delirium. Now, I was really confused when I first started which to try, mission or delirium. I started off with delirium and it was a little bit too uncomfortable for me, so I swapped over to mission and it was completely fine and I was getting used to it. Now, the reason is mission is a lot more smoother of a ride, and delirium basically outputs more torque and you're going to use more battery power because of it. So that's kind of like the difference. Mission mode is going to basically have less stress on your body, on your legs, on your ankles, or on your foot in my case. And so it turned out best for me. And once I get comfortable enough on mission mode, I'm sure I'll move on to delirium. So my recommendation to you, whoever's out there, if you're first starting off riding the one wheel, try out with mission first and then go on to delirium. But that's just my personal opinion and my personal experience. Okay, so the fourth thing, quickly I want to mention, just my foot. Yes, I am flat-footed, as I was mentioning, and it still hurts. I'm in a few weeks now, and still, I'm not very used to it yet, and so I can't ride for very long stints. And the smoother the pavement is, the longer I can ride. I did go on the Facebook group and asked if someone else had a flat foot like me, and they all did mention that yes, they are getting their stress on the foot, but it gets better over time, so I'm pretty hopeful. And then I do also want to mention tire pressure. So I'm running at 14 psi right now, and the factory is 20 psi, which can be too stiff and too responsive for beginners, and I was getting speed wobbles as well, so lowering the pressure helped get rid of that, and it can absorb the impact better and acts like a suspension system, which the one wheel doesn't have. Lastly, have fun. Yeah, just, you know, this thing, it's made to have fun. It's a no-brainer, yes, but do have fun. Leave a comment below if I missed anything as far as a beginner should know. What would you tell the newcomers or people who are trying to purchase one, but they're just not sure if it's the right thing for them? Yeah, leave it in the comments. And so, yeah, thanks for watching this video, really. I do really appreciate it. If you really like this video and if it, you know, helped you at all, please leave a like. It really does make a difference and it does help my channel to grow. So if you leave a like for me, I'd really appreciate it. If you want to change my life, go ahead and hit that subscribe button, hit that bell notification too, so you won't miss my next video. And yeah, so this is Slatterk Dan. Thank you for watching my video. And yeah, I will see you guys in the next video.